We're now joined by PAOK spokesperson Winston Casio to give us some updates on the recent victories against illegal POGO operations. Good afternoon, Mr. Casio, and welcome to Top Story.
Good afternoon, Stanley, and thanks for having me.
It's good to have you here again. Now, we want to know more about the latest raid in Fontana, where a supposed manager of one of the corporations or the businesses linked to illegal POGOs was arrested. Now, what more information can you share with us about him?
Well, with regards to that individual, we've got good reason to suspect that he was able to escape from Sunyu One during our initial raid last March 14.
Okay.
And we're still trying to verify as to his identity. Take note, Stanley, that most of these individuals hide behind fake identities. So he said that he has been in the Philippines for the past 10 years as a VIP junket operator, no? But in some instances during our discussions, he also said that he is just a chef or someone connected to a culinary business. I really don't know as to when he would come up with his final story. But as far as we are concerned, we're validating reports that he was one of the managers who was able to escape from Sunyu One last March 14. Incidentally, Stanley, last night, the Clark Development Corporation, together with the Bureau of Immigration, served a mission order against some individuals inside Fontana Leisure Park. And they were able to find three confirmed high-value targets that are related to Sunyu One and Lucky South 99 in Porac, Pampanga.
Okay.
So they were already inquested this afternoon.
Okay, and aside from those individuals, of course, you were targeting, I mean, at least before the raid happened, you were targeting some bigwigs or high-profile individuals believed to be connected to a lot of these POGO operations, both in Tarlac and Pampanga. And apparently, they were able to flee after or before the operatives even arrived in the area. Now, are there efforts to pursue them right now?
Yes, Stanley, we do have concerted efforts, multi-agency efforts to be able to get these individuals back. We've got good leads as to where they are, and give and take a few days, we'll be able to get them, just like what we did in Fontana this last few days. We may not have gotten them in Porac or in Bamban, but at the end of the day, we're certain that we're going to get them all.
Okay, now, during the latest raid as well, you were able to arrest a former policeman, a security guard, and an interpreter. Do you believe you can extract more information from these individuals as you investigate?
Now, let's look at them one at a time.
Okay.
Now, the security guard has nothing to do with any operation whatsoever. He's just doing his job, securing a private residence. So we had to release the individual given that we had nothing on him. Now, with regards to the former police officer, the dismissed police officer whom we... whom we caught, for lack of a better term, during the raid at Fontana last Thursday, we were unable to file the necessary charges against him within the number of hours allowed to us by law. So we just released him. But then again, despite releasing him, we got all of his information so that once we have enough to file any charges against him, we would be able to do that. Now, the translator, on the other hand, has been cooperating with us, and he has been saying that he's only a quote-unquote a translator, nothing more and nothing less. So that's where we stand as far as those three individuals are concerned, Stanley.
Okay, Winston, given all of your accomplishments recently, both in Tarlac and Pampanga, you're almost seeing all the links getting clear. You're connecting the dots. With everything that you've discovered, the evidence, you believe you have a stronger case now against Mayor Alice Goh?
Yeah, we do. We're very confident, Stanley, that we've got enough, got the goods on the on Goh Wah Ping. No, I'd hate to call her mayor anymore. Because as far as I am concerned, she does not deserve that title. She has bastardized our system, and we're going to make sure that we're going to throw everything at her.
Okay, and as this investigation, of course, expands into a more involvement of maybe a lot of Philippine officials, I'd like to quote a Rappler article quoting PAGCOR saying a cabinet official, a former cabinet official, in fact, has been behind the lobbying for the operations of these illegal POGO operations. I don't know if you can share more information about that with us right now.
I would defer to PAGCOR
okay.
as to whom who that particular former cabinet official is, given that we've had no interference whatsoever from any official, both current and previous. So I guess at the end of the day, in a day or two, I hope,
yeah.
PAGCOR would illuminate Announce. Us, enlighten us as to who this particular individual is, so that he or she could become part of our ongoing investigation as well.
So as of now, this individual is not yet part of your investigation, but are you looking at some links? What are the possibilities that this person is in fact involved in lobbying or pushing for the operations of these illegal businesses?
So, Stanley, we'd have to wait for PAGCOR to provide to us the documents or testimonial evidence that they have in relation to the said former cabinet official. But once we do have that information on hand, something that we could take action on, then we will leave no stone unturned. But as of this moment, we have nothing on anybody in relation to any possible interference by a former cabinet official.
Okay, lastly, Winston, and before we go, on another story from the PAOK. This is involving the supposed land acquisition, the massive land acquisition by foreigners in Nueva Ecija and Palawan. What more can you share with us about this, and perhaps what is the kind of collaboration that you will be having with concerned government agencies as regards these stories?
Stanley, this disturbing phenomenon is not a new phenomenon. Mm. We've seen this as far, we've seen this as far as Cagayan Valley. We've submitted a report to concerned agencies in relation to some huge tracts of land being allegedly bought by foreign nationals in areas such as Palawan, Nueva Ecija, and Cagayan. Cagayan okay. Valley in the north. And we've made those reports and submitted them in as much as we're kind of anxious as to their real intention. Mm-hmm. As our good Undersecretary Gilbert de la Cruz stated in a previous interview, this could possibly affect our food security if they, at the end of the day, be able to control the prices of our basic commodities, mm-hmm. such as our basic staple, rice. But more than food security, I'm pretty certain that this would also affect our national security, because some of the lands that are being bought by foreign nationals appear to be located near, adjacent okay. to enhanced defense cooperation agency sites, ETCA okay. sites. So we have to take a look at them seriously, that is.
And lastly, of course, before we go, Winston, we just want to ask you about the assets that you've seized in some of your recent raids. What is going to happen to these assets, properties, even the vaults, the contents of the vaults? Will this be forfeited to the government now?
Yeah. Now, with regards to the vaults, all of them have been submitted in our return of the warrant, so they would form part of evidence, so to speak. Then later on, if the case, as the case progresses, we would file civil forfeiture in relation to all of those monies and other valuables that we have found in all of the raids that we have conducted.
Okay.
In relation to real estate properties, Stanley, the AMLC will file the appropriate civil forfeiture so that once we forfeit them, it will go to our national treasury.
All right, Mr. Winston John Casio, we do hope to touch base with you again for more updates on these developing stories. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you, Stanley. Have a good day.
All right.